Hi friends, welcome back to Angular Hero to Superhero series. If you are a beginner trying to learn Angular, there is another series, Angular Zero to Hero, in which I have explained all the basic concepts. You can find the link in the description. In this Angular series, Hero to Superhero, I'm focusing on advanced concepts. In this video, I'm going to explain how we can integrate Firebase in Angular. Let's start. What is Firebase? Why we need that? Firebase is an entire platform for building apps with authentication, hosting, a database backend, storage, analytics, and more. Firebase is also a backend as a service. It is easy to integrate with Angular, Android, etc. Let us see how we can integrate Firebase in Angular. I have created a simple application to explain Firebase integration, authentication, Firestore, and storage. In this application, I have a home page in which I have an upload button. When the user clicks this button, if the user is already logged in, then the user should be taken to this upload page where user can upload an image to storage. In case user is not logged in, user will be taken to a login page where user can log in or register using Firebase authentication. For that, first we need to create a Firebase project and integrate that with this Angular application. To create a Firebase project, I need to go to console.firebase.google.com. Here, I can click this button to create a project. Let me give the name as Firebase Demo. And then let me click continue. I don't want analytics for this project. Let me toggle this. And let me click this button. Now the project is getting created. Okay, it is created. Let me click continue. Now let me go to my command prompt. Let me stop my application. Then I can use this command ng add at angular/fire. Enter. And then I need to give y. It is installing. Now I can choose the features I want. Let me choose authentication, Firestore, and cloud storage. And then let me click enter. These installations usually take some time. In the meantime, let me go to Firebase console, let me expand build, and then click Firestore database, and click this button to create a database. Let me start in test mode, and click continue. And let me choose region, and click enable. Database is getting created. Okay, it is created. Now I need to click this to see project settings. And here I need to choose a platform. Let me choose web. Let me give a name and click register app. Let's copy this to integrate Firebase in our application. I can copy this configuration object and let me put this in my environment files like this. We can also see our Firebase packages are also installed. And now I can start the server. Now Firebase is integrated. And then in app module TS, I can import the Angular Fire module, which is present in this package. And I can initialize the app using the configuration in the environment file. Let's first start with authentication. We shall use an email and password based authentication. For that, we need to import the Angular Fire Auth module, which is present in this package. And let me go to the login page. Here, let's start with register functionality. Firebase is providing us an inbuilt method to register. In our auth service, let me create a new function called signup, which accepts two parameters, email and password. In the constructor, let me inject Angular Fire Auth, which is in this package. And inside signup function, I can use the inbuilt method create user with email and password. And here, let me pass the email and password. Let me return this. And so I can process the response in my login component. Coming back to login component, first let me inject the auth service in the constructor. And inside register method, let me call the signup method from auth service and let me pass this email and password. Actually, I should have validated the inputs before passing it to Firebase. But I'm not going to cover those here because I'm going to pass only valid email format and password in this demo. And this is going to give us a promise. And so I can use the then method to resolve that. And I can show some message in the screen or show a toast or something. But now let me use an alert. Now if I test, this will not work. We get an error. Configuration not found. This is because we need to do one more step in the Firebase console. We need to enable the authentication. For that, let me go to authentication under build. And here let me click get started. And then let me choose the sign in method, email password. Let me enable and click save. Okay, now let me show you the users tab. Here we don't have any users. Now let me try to submit it again. Okay, the account is created. Now if I refresh here, we can see this user. In case you like to maintain a record in a separate user collection, you can make use of Firestore module. If I console log this result.user, we can see after I register an user, Firebase is returning us an user object. This has some information like email, unique user ID, etc. Okay. First, let me create a function in auth service called setUserData, which accepts the user and a full name. Let me inject the Angular Firestore from this package. And inside setUserData function, let me create an user reference which is equal to this.afs.docofusers/user.uid. This will create an users collection and create the document with ID as users ID. Then let me create an user data object which contains all the details need to be stored. Here let me get some information from user object and let me also store the full name. And then let me set the user data in the user reference and let me give merge true. This will act as update. And finally let me return this so that I can use it in login component. In login component, let me call setUserData from the auth service. And let me pass the user from result and the full name. Again, this is going to give us a promise. And so let me use then to resolve this too. Inside that, I can move this alert. Let me also clear the input fields after it is success. Okay, let me test. We can see users collection is created and the new user details are added. Let us add some code to complete our login requirement. First, let me create a function in auth service called signin. Let me copy the signup function and reuse. Let me change the create user to signin. Okay, let me go back to login component and copy this and change according to signin. And in auth service, let me create another function to return the authentication state. In login page, I can subscribe to this function and I can route the user to the upload page. Let me also set the isLoggedIn flag in local storage to true because this is what we are using in authguard to prevent unauthorized user to access upload page. In real situation, we use a token. For this demo, I'm just using a flag. Okay, let me test it. Initially, we are not logged in. And so when we click this upload button, we are going to login page. When I give my registered email ID and password, I'm logged in. And so I can see the upload page. Now let's use the storage module to upload an image. First, let me add a change event and call a function. Let me also create that function. Inside this function, let me get the file first from event.target.filesof0. And I need to have an unique file name. Let me use the timestamp for that. And let me create a file path using a folder name called images and then this timestamp. Now let me inject the Angular file storage in the constructor. And and then here I can create a file reference which is equal to this.storage.ref of file path. And then let me create a task to upload the image file using the inbuilt upload function in the storage. Then I can use the snapshot changes to get the download URL. And assign it to this variable, like this. Finalize is an operator from RxJS. I can test it, but it will not work. Like how we enabled the authentication in Firebase, we need to change some permission. For that, we need to go to console.cloud.google.com. Then here, we need to select our project. Then in the left menu, we need to select cloud storage and buckets. Then we need to select all buckets and click permissions. There we need to click add principal. In new principal, we need to give the email ID firebase-storage@system.gserviceaccount.com. And we need to search and give storage admin in the role input box. Then we need to save it. And finally, in Firebase console, we need to open the storage module, and in rules tab, we need to change this to true and publish it. Ideally, we need to give more specific rule here, but for this demo, let me give it as true. After it is published, we can test. We can see it is uploaded successfully, and we can see our image here. Also, if we go to the Files tab, inside this Images folder, we can see our image file. Hope you understood about how we can use Firebase in Angular applications. Please like this video, subscribe, and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.